You're starting to go bald. Do you hang on to every hair you have left or bite the bullet and shave your head? Hey guys, my name is Annie and in this video we discuss why it's so hard for balding men to shave their heads and find out what society really thinks of bald men. If you are losing your hair, there is a moment when you can't ignore it any longer. You have some options, but not a lot of good ones. You could get a hair transplant, which is not a pleasant procedure. Or you can start hair loss treatment, which is costly, and in case of ceasing the procedure, hair loss starts over. Various polls prove that it's better to shave your head if you are balding than fighting a losing battle. But why is it so difficult to pull that plug? I do believe that it takes a certain level of confidence for men to shave their heads. We as a society don't mock baldness nearly so often as we mock attempts to hide baldness. You have different concerns regarding the overall looking without any hair, and that is just fine. You're going to take a step forward and change your look. What if your friends and family don't like it? What if you will be no longer interesting for the opposite sex? What if you look too old? Asking yourself these questions is quite legit. However, in most cases, you're overreacting. Balding men usually appear not only about 5 or 10 years older than their peers, but also less agreeable, less assertive, and less attractive, which unsurprisingly has been linked with poor self-esteem and body image and with higher stress and depression. According to various polls, men who shave their heads are perceived as more confident and masculine than men with full heads of hair. And I'd imagine way more so than men with obviously thinning hair. A series of 3 studies published in the journal Social, Psychological and Personality Science proves this statement. Participants were asked to rate men with different hairstyles and several different traits, such as dominance, attractiveness, age, and physical strength. In the first study, 59 female university students saw pictures of 25 men, both black and white. 10 of the men had shaved heads, while the others had various hair lengths, but no visible signs of balding. The short men were consistently ranked as more dominant. The last 2 studies relied on panels of adult Americans recruited online. In the first, 367 adults rated 8 photographs of the same man from the first study. Half of the participants saw original photos with hair, and the other half saw photos that had been doctored so the man's head looked shaved. Dominance, masculinity, age, height, physical strength, and confidence were all ranked higher in the shaved versions. In fact, shaved men were viewed as nearly an inch taller and 13% stronger than their counterparts who had hair. They were also seen as less attractive, however. In the last study, 588 adults read a description of a normal man. In one version, the man was described as having a full head of hair. In another, he had naturally thinning hair, and in a third, he had shaved his head. Again, the short man was seen as more dominant, more masculine, and stronger, while the naturally balding man was ranked lowest in the desirable traits. So, all these studies prove, when balding sets in, men might do better to just shave it off. The causality is not that shaving makes men more confident, it's the reverse. For 2 men who are at similar level of hair loss, the more confident one is more likely to shave his head than the less confident one. The conclusion of this video is way too simple. Stop clinging to hair and you will probably be happier. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe if you have not already. My name is Annie and I will see you next time.